What's a NeRF?
NeRF is a neural radiance field. New views ever seen can be revealed from images, and each camera's pose train a modular perceptron, so it knows the radiance from each location and density information. Let's sort of explain it in reverse and talk about rendering first. You don't need a grid or mesh or surface. The way to visualise a NeRF is volume rendering. Through each pixel's place, project an array from the camera center into space. Much along the way, sample it in chunks and pass to the rendering function each chunk's radiance and density from the MLP to the pixel's RGB. Render more realistic views. Your lighting model shouldn't be totally diffused. To handle scenes with specular reflectance, use ray directions. That's view dependent. The sum of the squares of the rendered RGBs take the crash with images. If you lost the MLP, back propagates. And you may appreciate this is trivial to differentiate. For greater resolution, make training chunks random. Additive for speed, train two NeRFs in tandem. Coarse and fine levels, and sample stratified. The coarse NeRF's density is used as a guide to occupancy. Fine samples are biased toward points on the ray where density is highest. And if you want to see more detail in your scene map, it's
a B2.
Sampling one ray per pixel camera blocky and historical, instead sample frustums exact or conical. Make up bounded scenes effectively small by contracting coordinates to inside a ball. To disentangle object and lighting interference, separate static and transient appearance. And for greater speed, use many tiny MLPs or use nanomodel radiance. Pixel camera poses can't be trusted. Train the NeRF while they're bundle adjusted. When you put a few, send the NeRF with prize or a light template motion order form is required. Generate NeRFs through a text prompt instruction or edit them by giving instructions with the trained objects, export them in a mesh or use them directly in effects.